What's up, guys? It's Tom. Welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to teach you guys how to use a ghost track to trigger your sidechain compression and create some really cool rhythmic patterns for your synth. First things first, I know what you're thinking. Tom, what the hell is a ghost track? Well, put quite simply, a ghost track is a track in your DAW that you create that you mute and hide, but you use its rhythmic value to control patterns on a compressor through sidechain on a different instrument. So you don't actually hear the ghost track instrument itself, you just hear its effects. So with that being said, let's dive into Logic and I'll show you what I'm talking about. All right, so I've got a little pattern set up here, just a like mini little session, and I've just got kick, snare, a bass track, and a synth track. So let me show you what we're working with and then we'll dive in. Right? So, kind of a basic little chord progression here. Big bass, big burly synth, kick and snare. So, first things first, I've already got sidechain compression on the bass from the kick drum. Right? So, that's already going. If you don't know how I did that and what sidechain is, period, go check out my other video on sidechain compression with the kick drum and the bass specifically to catch you up. It's really short, pretty simple. So we've got sidechain on the bass. Now what we're going to do is we're going to add it to the synth track. So first things first, I'm going to go to my compressor here and I'm going to start with the FET because I like it. And I'm going to close that. Well, let me make sure my volume's right. So we got a synth going on the, we have a compressor going on the synth track. Now comes the fun part. Let's make a ghost track. So I'm going to do Option Command S to create a new software instrument track. I'm going to hit Y to bring up my menu. And I'm going to try to find a sound that I like. Actually, I know which sound I like. I'm not going to try to find anything. When you're triggering from a ghost track, it's important to keep in mind what sound you're using. It does make a difference. So if you have a big, long wave of a kick drum, then the trigger time is going to be slower and longer. If that's what you want, that's cool. If you want it faster, shorter, and crisper, then you want to use something that's got a short attack and a short decay. So I have this little snare drum that I like. It's in Atlanta, the Atlanta setting here on in Logic. That right there. Really short, to the point. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try to figure out a pattern that I like, that I want the hit Y to get that to go away, that I want the synth to play, and then I'm gonna record that in. So let's figure out a pattern. Cool. Yeah, let's record that in. All right. Now I'm going to double click this to pull up the piano roll. I'm going to select all. I'm just going to quantize real quick because I want to make sure everything is rhythmically where I want it to be. Then I'm going to hit Command 9 to bring up the MIDI editor window. I'm going to go to Fixed Velocity on the top drop-down menu here. And I'm just going to hit Operate. Just wait. That way it's all set to the exact same velocity. So it's the exact same amount of sidechain compression happening each time. Hit P to close that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Control B. And that's going to print this to an audio track. We'll call it Ghosty. Yeah. Ghost E, why not? So there's our little ghosty track there, as you can see. I'm gonna mute this and then solo this. Here's our ghost track. Okay, so pretty straightforward. Still with me? Now I'm going to open up the synth track. I'm going to go to the compressor here. I'm going to pull up Sidechain at the top right of this drop-down menu. I'm going to go to audio. I'm going to select Ghosty. Now let's listen. So you hear how it's already doing something? But let's make it even more dynamic. So I'm making the attack and the release really short. Again, I covered this in another video of mine on sidechain compression with the kick and the bass drum. But in short, a shorter attack is the shorter amount of time that it's going to take for your compressor to start from being triggered to hit maximum compression. Then the release is going to be the amount of time from when it's at maximum compression to when it's done. So with something like this, where we want this really quick rhythmic value, we want to have a short release and a short attack. That way it's in and out very quickly and we get that bouncing poppy sound. That's what we want. So now we've got it kind of set where we want it. I'm going to get rid of this ghost track. I'm just going to hit mute real quick. And again, the synth is still going to play off of this track. Check it out. Right? Pretty cool. So now let's listen to it in context. You hear how it's a little bit behind the beat? It's a little bit far back. So I'm going to adjust the attack and release to see if I can't bring it up rhythmically a little bit more so that it's a bit more in time. Just like that, sidechain from a ghost track. You don't hear the ghost track, but you do hear its effects. It's a really, really cool, interesting tool that you can use. You can try all kinds of different rhythmic variations. Obviously, try different sounds, see what effects they have. There's really no end to this. This is a great way to automate your synth, especially if you want to get a feel for what you're trying to get it to do while it's still a MIDI file before you print it to audio. So it was a great trick. It's a lot of fun to play with. And I hope that it helps. If you want to hear anything else, if you want to learn about anything else, hit me up in the comments section and let me know what you're interested in knowing, and I will do my best to distill it down and send it back to you in another video. And if you like this, hit the subscribe button. That's it for this video, and I will catch you next time. Peace.